Sometimes the SOLIDWORKS materials are close to the material we want to use, but there are a few changes that needs to be done. And in this video, I will show you how to modify materials and to add tables. In this case, I want to use a temperature-dependent version of the 2014-10-6 aluminium alloy. As you can see, I am not allowed to make any changes to the material in the SOLIDWORKS library. Luckily, we can copy existing materials by right-clicking them and say copy or use Ctrl-C. And then we can go into our custom materials. I'll add a new category and call it temperature dependent. And then I can paste the material here. And then we are allowed to make changes. And the first thing I want to do is to make the elastic modulus temperature dependent. I'll do that by using the drop down menu. And then I'll redirect to tables and curves. First thing is to make sure that I have the right units. Then I'll use an Excel sheet with the values. I'll use Ctrl C to copy it. And then I'll go back to SOLIDWORKS and Ctrl V to paste. I also want to make the yield strength temperature dependent. So I'll do the same, change my units. Go back to the Excel sheet, copy, and paste. Since I made a table first this time, I need to go back to the properties, but before that, remember to save the changes. Luckily, if you forget, SOLIDWORKS will remind you. Then I'll set yield strength to be temperature dependent also, and this automatically brings me back to tables and curves tab, and I can verify that both my tables were saved earlier. I'll save it again since I made the temperature dependent changes in the property manager, and then I can apply my materials.